Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. So today we are making a video on programming in Java. So we are discussing about Java differs from C and CPP. So topics we need to cover: Java and C and Java and C++, Java and Internet, Java and World Wide Web, Java and Web Browser, and hardware and software requirements for installing Java. So the first one is Java and C. Java is a lot like C, but the major difference between Java and C is that Java is an object-oriented language and has mechanism to define classes and objects. In an effort to build a simple and safe language, the Java team did not include some of the C features in Java. So Java does not include the C Unix statement keywords go to size of and type def. Java does not contain the data types struct, union, and enum. Java does not define the type modifiers keywords auto, extend, register, signed, and unsigned. Java does not support an explicit pointer type. Java does not have a preprocessor, and therefore we cannot use hash define, hash include, and hash if def statements. Java does not support any mechanism for defining variable arguments to functions. Java requires that the functions with no arguments must be declared with empty parentheses and not with the void keyword as done in C language. Now we need to know the difference between Java and CPP. Java is a true object-oriented language, while C++ is basically C with object-oriented extension. C++ has maintained background compatibility with C. It is therefore possible to write an old-style C program and run it successfully under CPP. Java appears to be similar to C++ when we consider only the extension part of C++. However, some object-oriented features of C++ make the C++ code extremely difficult to follow and maintain. Java does not support operator overloading. One thing I note that what are the things not supported in Java with C are applicable with addition to that we are adding. Java does not support operator overloading. Java does not have template classes as in C++. Java does not support multiple inheritance of classes. This is accomplished using a new feature called interface. Java does not support global variables. Every variable and method is declared within a class and forms part of that class. Java does not use pointers. Java has replaced the destructor function with a finalize function. There are no header files in Java. Now Java and Internet. Java is strongly associated with the Internet because of the fact that the first application program written in Java was Hotjava, a web browser to run applets on Internet. Internet users can use Java to create applet programs and run them locally using a Java-enabled web browser, such as Hotjava. Internet users can also set up their websites containing Java applets that could be used by other remote users of Internet. The ability of Java applets to hitch a ride on the information superhighway has made Java a unique programming language for the Internet. In fact, due to this, Java is popularly known as Internet language. So, Java is introduced for the development of internet applications. Java and World Wide Web. World Wide Web, WWW, is an open-ended information retrieval system designed to be used in the internet's distributed environment. This system contains what are known as web pages that provides both information and controls. Java was meant to be used in distributed environments such as internet. Since both the web and Java share the same philosophy, Java could be easily incorporated into the web system. Before Java, the World Wide Web was limited to the display of still images and texts. However, the incorporation of Java into web pages has made it capable of supporting animation, graphics, games, and a wide range of special effects. With the support of Java, the web has become more interactive and dynamic. On the other hand, with the support of web, we can run a Java program on someone else's computer across the internet. Now, web browsers. Web browser is nothing but the interpreter. It is an interpreter to run HTML, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, etc., etc. code. Internet is a vast sea of information represented in many formats and stored on many computers. A large portion of the internet is organized as the World Wide Web, which uses hypertext. Web browsers are used to navigate through the information found on the internet. They allow us to retrieve the information spread across the internet and display it using the hypertext markup language HTML. Examples of web browsers: Hot Java, Netscape Navigator, Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, UC Browser, Opera, etc. Now, the hardware and software requirements. Minimum operating system required: any compatible operating system, RAM, minimum 512 MB, processor P3 or higher, JDK 1.5 or 1.6, but present latest version is 13.0. Editors: Notepad, Eclipse, JCreator, EditPlus, JBuilder, and NetBeans. Many more tools are available, but we have mentioned only few things. Hardware: hard disk drive, minimum requirement for storing the project. Thank you.